All right, so this one is the third in a series of how tall is this tree problem. Okay. So it tells us that the man here is 6 feet tall. So of course we want to make a note of that in the picture. It's very helpful in the picture to make a note of that kind of thing. His shadow is 10 feet long. Okay, so from there to there. And then we talked about how the tree is 50 feet away from the man, right? From here to here is 50 feet. Okay? That's not quite what we want to know, because we want information about these triangles. One of them is here, and the bigger one is there, like either encapsulates the smaller one. So how can I use this 50 to tell me something about the larger triangle?
Yeah.
Well, we can add that to 10 of the smaller triangle and get 60.
Right, so from there to there is 60. Okay, so if we were to kind of split apart these two triangles, essentially we'd have a larger triangle that's 60 on the base, and we don't know anything else about this thing. This smaller one is 6. High, 6 feet tall, and 10 feet at the base. And the only reason why it's important that we know those things, the only reason that's useful, is because, put it in the phone jail, please, is because these two triangles are they have a very special relationship. On the podium, please. These two triangles are what?
Similar.
Very important. Similar. Dalton.
Every 6 feet. It adds 4 feet on top of that, so the shadow does.
Every 6 feet, it adds 4 feet?
Yeah. Like, the guy is 6 foot tall, and it added 4 to his shadow and got 10.
No, it doesn't quite work that way, that this would add 6 and this would add 4. That's not quite the...
I mean, similar. Instead of the shadow being the same size as the guy is, it's 4 feet taller than he is.
Well, like if I made this shadow, or if I made this triangle bigger and bigger and bigger, that wouldn't always be the case. So if I made this 10 feet tall, that would mean, well, let's see. If I made this 12 feet tall, that doesn't mean that I would add just 4 more feet.
No, you would add 4 feet to get 10 feet.
Right, 4 more feet. That would make it 14. Okay, but that's not the case. If I made this side, like if I made this side 6 feet taller to make it 12 feet.
That one would be 20.
Right.
Yeah, so
60 by 10 is 6. So we can see how this is,
it's 6 times.
Like this one's twice as big, right?
Yeah.
This triangle's twice as big as this one. This one is what?
6 times.
6 times as big.
So then
so this multiplies by 6 to get 60. So we'd multiply this by 6.
Times 6.
We get 36. So the tree is 6 feet tall. Zach?
Did you get the. Miss Hauser told me to turn mine in to her yesterday.
Sandy.
Sandy.
Yeah, she had us give the mom.
We're just going to do it again because it sounds like.
Do it again.
Some did it okay, some didn't.
Okay.
Like
this one again?
No. The one that she handed out yesterday.
That one's so good.
I turned the similar triangles in yesterday.
Oh, that
one. Leave it on her desk.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. If you turned it in, there's some of them on my desk that
okay.
I found when someone told me they turned it in. Okay, so this one. Very, very similar. It's got two triangles. Right? But it's a different situation. It's not shadows and trees and people.
Phones and TVs.
And it's not even... Well, here, let me say it this way. If I were to, like, stoop down and put my eye right here at the edge of this triangle, or not the edge, the corner of this triangle right here, and I were to look at the guy, he would completely block my view of this tree. Perfect. Not just kind of, or more than necessary. Like, I would see, like if I move my head just a little bit, I would just see the top of this tree peek out above.
above his head. Okay, but if I put my eye right there, the man and the tree would look the same size. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Right? You know what forced perspective is?
Yeah.
What's that? Yeah, it looks bigger than it actually is. So like in movies, sometimes they'll make, especially older, black and white, silent movies, they would make one person look like a giant, another person look really small, and they just did that by having somebody stand close, and the other person be far away, and they would just act, and this person would act like they're picking up this small person, but really the person's way over there, right? So as forced perspective, this guy and this tree would look exactly the same height, even though I know they're not, okay? But if I took a picture, okay, they would look the same size. Jackson?
I saw this thing that was forced perspective in there. Toy model cars on this little thing, and they took a picture from the right angle, and it looked like they were on the street.
Oh yeah, I saw that too.
Wow.
It can be fun to play around with that. Especially when you take a picture of it, because pictures are in 2D, two dimensions, so we can't get that they're at different depths.
Have you seen those pictures where people like have to get good perspectives, and they're like, have their hands at certain spots and like holding up the Eiffel Tower like the moon or something?
Yeah, a lot of people do that. I actually saw a picture of a bunch of people in front of the Eiffel Tower, all of them doing something like this, just like a big open field of people all posing for pictures where they're holding up the Eiffel Tower. Yeah, it was pretty funny.
I'm
gonna get back to this now. Guys, crossing over. The place where it's too much. So in this scenario, it's not about using this to figure out how big this is. What we're really doing is figuring out, well, this person is holding this phone. I think about this, I watch a lot of Netflix on my phone, and so I think, like, how big of a screen does this seem like, or is it the same as if it were, like, over on the wall?
I do that too.
I wonder, yeah, so I just hold it up and, like, that's kind of a big screen, bigger than my TV if I hold it close enough, or if I'm far enough away from the wall, okay? So we're just figuring out, to her eye, how big a TV does her phone look like? That's basically what the question boils down to. So, let's see, the first piece of information is that she's holding it 1 foot away from her eye. So 1 foot. That little apostrophe means foot. The screen is 3 inches tall as it's laying sideways like this. It's 3 inches tall. The wall in front of Elise is 10 feet away, so here's her eye, and 10 feet away is the wall. So from here all the way to her eye, not to the phone. How tall would a TV have to be in order to appear as large as the phone screen, right? So like how big would this TV be if it was being perfectly covered up by this phone screen? Well, we have two similar triangles. This one right here, which is 3 inches tall but 1 foot at the base. Now there's something about that.
They're different measurements,
yes.
So you'd have to convert feet into inches.
Okay, feet into inches. You could do inches into feet, right?
Yeah.
Or do feet into inches. Weird. So instead of that, we'll make this 12 inches. So 10 feet, 12 feet, 12 inches per foot for 10 feet, 120 inches. Half a quotation mark is inches. All right, so now we have comparable measurements. This is 3 tall and 12 at the base. This is 120 at the base, right? And it's going to be a similar triangle to this one. So how does that help us? Figure out that larger triangle is what? 10 times as big as the smaller triangle.
Yeah, so then 30 inches big is the TV, after you go 10 times 3 because it's 10 times bigger. And so
you get the small triangle, it's 12 by 3. You got this big old triangle, which is definitely similar. How do we know it's similar?
Because they have the same angles.
They have the same angles. Now, just as a side note, if they have the same angles, if the triangles have the same angles, then they're similar. But if rectangles have the same angles, that does not mean they're similar.
Because all rectangles have the
same. All rectangles have the same angles. So it works, this that check only works for triangles. If triangles have all the same angles, 3 is a really neat, special number. When you have 3 sides and 3 angles, then it works out nicely that if they have the same angles, all 3 angles are the same, then they're similar. Okay, so this everything about this triangle is 10 times bigger than this one. Except for, is that completely true? Is everything about this triangle 10 times as big as this triangle?
No.
What is not 10 times as big?
The angles.
Good. I didn't even think of that. The angles are not 10 times as big. They're exactly the same. Okay. But there is something that's bigger, but it's not 10 times as big.
The hypotenuse?
Well, would the hypotenuse be 10 times as big as this hypotenuse?
I don't know.
It would. I mean, if they're similar and this side is 10 times as big as this correlated side, then all of them are 10 times as big, right? That's how we're figuring out that this is, well, how big is this?
30.
It would have to be 30 inches tall. Pretty big TV. And the hypotenuse, if we cared how big the hypotenuse was, that would just be like, let's think about what the hypotenuse would actually measure. How far from her eye to the very top of her phone screen, or the hypotenuse of the larger one, from her eye to the top of the TV screen. Not an incredibly useful measurement, right? I don't know why I would want to know that. So what about this triangle again? What about this triangle is not 10 times as big? The hypotenuse is 10 times as big.
Angles.
The 10, right, the angles. The what? The area is not 10 times as big. Not 10 times big. Does anybody remember how many times bigger the area would be? 10 times bigger?
5.
Well, it's 10 times bigger this way, and it's 10 times bigger this way.
10 times
this would be 100 times bigger. The area would be 100 times the area of this triangle. Not that that's very useful for these triangles. Look, the area is just the area between these three sides, which, yeah, who cares what the area of that triangle is? Lastly, this one's interesting because we've got feet, we got inches, and we got miles.
Whoa.
Indeed. Okay, so let's see. When a piece of paper is held at arm's length, right? Like, arm's length means out this far. This far as my arm can reach. About 2 feet, okay? So what distance is 2 feet from?
34 inches.
No, I mean, what part of this diagram is 2 feet?
Isn't it from like the eye? Paper hole to the eye?
From the paper hole to the eye, yeah, so 2 feet.
This is bizarre. Everyone's arm is about 2 feet.
2 feet?
It's not bad. I mean,
not really.
Mine is about 2 feet.
I'm talking about this. Do you know if this is as tall as
yours?
Mine's taller.
Okay, 2 feet is how far away the paper is from the eye. Crisp is larger than the moon. The hole in the piece of paper is 5/16 of an inch across. Which means from there to there is 5/16 of an inch. Okay, I got that by measuring the hole in the piece of paper. The moon is 238,900 miles away. Okay, so that's from there to the moon. It is 238,900 miles.
900?
Yes.
Long way away.
That's miles. What did we have to do when we had this problem? Convert things to the same measurement.
Yeah.
Whether they be inches or feet, or we could have converted this to miles, and that would be kind of dumb to do.
It's gonna be a lot of inches.
But we should convert all of these 3 different kinds of measurement to the same thing. Whether we convert this up to miles and this up to miles, or this down to inches, and this down to inches, or this up to feet, and this down to feet. Like, whatever it is, we have to convert them all to the same thing, otherwise it's not all that helpful.
It's like feet.
Feet, okay, so this will be 2 feet. We gotta figure out how much of a foot this is, and how many feet this is. How do we do that?
How many feet are in a mile?
How many feet are in a mile? Is it 45 feet?
Not 5,000.
No,
5,000.
5,000.
5,214.
Nope. Close.
Is that 300?
5,317.
Nope.
15,315. 5,280. Oh, I think I was close on that one.
Okay. So what would we do with that information, 5,280 feet in a mile?
Times 12, and then times 238.
Oh, so now you're putting this in inches, then?
Yeah.
No, we're putting it into feet.
Consider this. Consider putting it into inches, okay? Now, this is 5/16 of an inch. That's not a great fraction. But this fraction of an inch is going to be probably even more of a unwieldy fraction of a foot, right? Because we have to figure out what fraction this is of a foot. So maybe if we brought this to inches and this to inches, we could at least just leave this as 5/16 of an inch.
Why don't we just bring them all to centimeters?
Yeah.
So 238,900. Times 5,280. If you multiply by 12, I mean, it's not going to be that much bigger. It's already pretty big.
Yeah.
Times 12.
I'll do that.
I'll do it first.
Let me just get a confirmation on this one.
Let's
do it.
Number one.
Dang, that's Stuart's beating
you. Yeah, it's too much work.
That's gonna be another
quiz
quote.
E10.
Yeah, I heard like
1.5. What's
E10
mean?
It won't even show it.
Yeah, it has
like
1.5
or 2. I'll tell you.
E stands for
exponent.
To the
10th
power.
Shut your mouth.
Right? So E10 means times 10 to the 10th power, which basically, you can just move this decimal place to the right 10 places, and you've got the number of inches. So, let's see. I can get this to stay on top.
Same as that right there.
So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We'll just throw some zeros on there. It doesn't tell us beyond that. Unless, does somebody have it on their iPhone?
Yeah, I do.
If you turn it sideways, does it go out to more places?
Yeah.
Yes,
it does.
Yeah.
Here. It has this stuff.
Right, but this number is what I'm looking for.
The
multiply everything.
I'm going to erase you.
15, 1, 3, 6, 7, 0, 4, 0, 0, 0, 0.
My brother
has
an app that has like everything on math.
You're right.
To the phone. Well, I'm just guessing because I don't know what's beyond this 4 according to this calculator.
It's 3 zeros.
Okay, so we're just kind of, I'm not.
You were dead on. Great job.
Wasn't my guess at the correct answer. I just didn't know what was there. So that's how many inches it is to the moon. Let's see how many inches. That's 1,000,000,000,000, 15,136,704,000 inches to the moon.
What's the 15?
This is, what? Yeah.
Because the top one's coming in.
All right, so we'll just switch this out to how many inches it is to the moon. Okay, this is easy, right? 2 feet is how many inches?
24
inches. And 5/16 of an inch. How are we going to figure out how many times bigger this is than this? What's that?
Divide
what?
That big number by that other number.
That big number by 24? Okay, so let's see, will it bring up what I just did? Okay, I'll divide that by 24. Oh, it brings it down. On top now. So, this big triangle to the moon is this many times as big
as
the little triangle between the eye and the piece of paper.
That's only 3 zeros.
Right.
What's that?
Oh, never mind. You don't say.
Okay.
It didn't help. It's still like in the billions place.
Is it billions? It's got thousand,
million,
million, hundreds of millions, 630 million, so on.
$630 million.
Okay.
Oh,
that would be a lot of dollars.
I want to hit 600.
There's so much money on
the chips. 6.5.
Let me divide it right.
6,000. Okay. It's difficult for me to feel a lot of compassion for you when you're confused about things when this is how class goes. So this big triangle is that many times as big as the small triangle, so what? How does that help me figure out how far across the moon is? Times what?
The fraction by the...
5/16 of an inch by this many times bigger the big triangle is. Okay. So multiply that by 5/16. 5/16. 197. 1970. 925.
You did times 5 divided by 16.
I did.
Yeah.
Is that wrong?
No. I think it is.
No, that's not a good attitude to have. You can question that, teacher. It's the same thing. If I were to, I mean, how would you write it? Let's look at what we've done in the previous examples. I figured out that this triangle is 10 times bigger, right? So I took this side and multiplied it by 10 to get 30, right? That's what I'm going to do here. I figured out that this triangle is 630,696,000 times as big as this little guy, right? So if I multiply 24 by that number, I would get this many inches. So I'm going to multiply this 5/16 of an inch by that same multiplier and get how big this is, which is how far across the moon is, the diameter of the moon. Okay. So I guess rest assured, multiplying that number there, right from the previous line, by 5 and dividing by 16, that's exactly the same as multiplying the fraction 5/16. Okay. So this. What is this?
Inches.
How many what?
Inches.
The moon is across. Do I want to know how many inches the moon is across?
That much.
I probably would like to know how many miles it is across.
So you transfer it into feet.
Transfer it into feet. How do I transfer this number into feet?
12.
Divided by 12. That's how many feet it is. How do I transfer that into miles?
Divided
by
the number of 5,280.
So 3,110.67. Now, this is the first time I've seen this answer. I don't know. I measured this hole. I said 24 inches because that's I know that you should hold your paper at about arm's length. These are all kind of approximations. So someone look up what's the diameter of the moon. Just take out your phone and look up what's the diameter of the moon.
Hey Siri, what's the diameter? Siri, what is the diameter of the moon?
I already have it.
Siri,
what is it?
What's the diameter?
It's 2,159.3 miles.
Yep. We're off by an entire thousand.
Okay, I'll be doing
what is it in inches?
What did we do wrong is a really good discussion to have. What did we do wrong?
I don't, well, wait, is that actually how far away the moon is from the hole?
Listen, please. We found the moon to be, listen, please. When I say listen, I think you know what that word means. We found the moon to be 3,110.677 miles across, like from pole to pole, if it had poles. I don't know if it does or not. But then we looked it up and found it was how many? 2,000 something? 2,000 what?
2,156.3.
156?
Hey Siri.
It's
2,156.
What is the diameter of the moon?
So
I did inches. 137.
What is the diameter of the moon?
The miles is fine. So we're off by 1,000. How could we be off by 1,000?
You did something wrong.
Yeah, it's 2,159.3.
So how, what did we do wrong? What could we have improved?
Our
math. We could just plus
add.
Our math is correct.
Okay.
So something about the setup is wrong. Like, what?
How far away the moon is?
Oh, they don't know how many miles away the moon is.
Maybe we had the wrong number of miles away that the moon is, but we don't, because I looked it up and that's how many miles away it is. You might find a difference of a few hundred miles or something, but I don't even think it's that. It's not even that much of a difference.
It's how far away you're holding your paper.
Okay, so if I go outside and I hold it out and it's at arm's length, is that 2 feet? Is it a little more? Is it a little less?
Yeah, how do you know?
A little more. That, now, it might not make much of a difference if I'm trying to figure out how tall a tree is. But when I take that measurement and I explode it out hundreds of thousands of miles, any small error becomes multiplied and multiplied and multiplied, okay, by that much. A small error is multiplied by hundreds of millions, okay? So I'm approximating that distance. I just took my ruler and it only goes to 16ths of an inch, so I measured it to the 16ths of an inch. I probably need a little more accuracy there, right? So these measurements are just not completely accurate. We got it.
Well, the math.
Well, listen, in the old days, the ancient Greeks and those guys, if they got that close, we would have considered it like, whoa, great job. But
I wish we could be that way, like, can help count if you get close.
Dude.
Jackson?
I forgot who it was, but I think it was a long time ago that someone tried measuring the diameter of Earth with the shadow thing.
Circumference.
With the
yeah,
shadow?
Mm-hmm. That's true.
Who was it?
I can't remember his name right now, but yeah. We can look at that. That used similar shapes as well.
That was our bell.
Okay. That wasn't your bell.
Oh, well done. I just
our bell's at 1051.
So, chillax. Alright, so I'm going to hand these back to you, and you're going to do this for homework. Okay? We just did three problems just like this. Just like this. Let me make it clear what information you need to gather, okay? What I want to know is the dimensions of the little flag I'm gonna draw on the paper, okay? This rectangle itself is going to be a scaled version of the flag, right? Going to be scaled down. It's going to be so many times smaller, or that triangle, or that rectangle is going to be so many times bigger than this one. What I'm trying to show you is we have two similar shape problems here. To figure that out, though, to figure out that scale, I need to think about these triangles as we've done so many times so far. Okay. So what I need to do is figure out what are the dimensions of the flag that I want to make. Okay. And you'll find that different countries, different states, different cities have different sized flags. Like, I mean, the ratio is different. Sometimes it's like 20 feet by 30 feet, but it might be 20 feet by 50 feet. It depends. Well, we want like a flagpole flag. We want a big guy that we would, the one that we would see from 100 feet away. Where you're gonna research how big flags are. Okay, you wanna look for the big ones that are in the like tens of feet. All right. It's all relative. I mean, Mexico has a flag at the border of California and Mexico that is massive. They're called monument flags. It's huge.
Is it like?
Okay. But it is a scale version of any of the Mexico flags that you might see, whether they're big ones or small ones. They're all scale versions of each other.
And then, like, we're just supposed to find that.
Find the size of a flag that you would actually put on a flagpole to be viewed from 100 feet away.
I have a flag.
Whoa.
There's no need to pack up. We have 3 minutes left. Please stop distracting class by talking and by zipping up your binders and all that stuff. So from the eye to the big flag, how far is that? We've been saying this is our standard 100 feet. 100 feet.
That would be a terrible flag. It would probably be below Proud to be Pocatello if we did
Proud to be Pocatello.
Yeah, I thought you might appreciate that inside joke.
What's the TM for?
Trademark.
Just like Pocatello.
That's so horrible. But they also have copyright on there too.
Yeah, I didn't go that far. So 100 feet from the eye to the flag, how far is it from your eye to the paper? You need to figure that out. Sit comfortably at a table and say, this is where the paper would be if I was to sketch out my design. Get a ruler, measure from your eye to the paper, right? Get a decent measurement, or decide how far you want it to be and just always make sure you hold your head if that just matters. Question?
So I'm sitting up like this, doing stuff. This is how far we fit it. That's how you measure it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Exactly.
That makes my sense.
Exactly. Okay, so then we'll know how far this is after you measure it, right? We'll know this, check. And so we'll have a base of this triangle, a base of this triangle, and we can easily find out how many times bigger this is than that, as we always have. We'll know how big this is because we'll have looked up how big we want our flag to ultimately be. And we can use that, kind of go backwards, right? You're gonna have to go back to the smaller triangle, and we'll be able to figure out what that is. Then, you'll know how big this is, you'll know how big this is. The flag itself on the paper is a scale version of the bigger flag, right?
Yeah.
And you'll know how many times bigger it is because it's the same as the two triangles. And now knowing how long this is, you can, and how long this is, because you've researched it already, you can figure out how long that is, okay? And that's what I'm gonna expect you to have when you come back to class. Let me pass this back out. So
you have something we already have those.
Some of you turned it in.
Yeah, we made a tournament.
Yeah, she made a tournament.
We have like 7 seconds.
Okay, well, actually.
Nope.
Sit back down.
I already got one. I still have one.
Okay, we need a ruler. Yeah, one's right there. I have one right there. Just take that one too.
Wow. Once everybody has their paper, and Emma has a seat as I ask you to have.
Sit down.
God.
Have a good day.